Hello world, microcats! Today we will work with such a module as a joystick. This is a two-axis handle on a ball and socket joint. The joystick generated signals for deflection of its handle in the plane of two mutually perpendicular axes. It also has a button. We collect the entire system as a whole and in order what is there. This is an ordinary RGB LED. This is the joystick itself. System brains on blue pill board and display to watch data. We turn on the power. We see what now the button is not pressed. The deviation along the axis is zero. The LED is off. Press the joystick button. We see what the LED lights up and the inscription on the display changes. Now we will deflect along the X axis. We will deflect to the right, to the left. The slider on the screen outlines the side of a joystick, and also the readings of the axis change. Now we will also deflect along the Y axis. We will deflect up and down. We deflect along several axes. Deflection with a held down button. Unfortunately, the quality of joystick itself leaves much to be desired. There is a backlash, not symmetry in the axis, but it can be useful for home crafts. Consider the electrical circuit. To showing data, we use the ST7735 display and also RGB LED KY-016. The joystick used is the KY-023 modular. Pay attention to the completion of the circuit for the resistor R5. This refinement reduces bounds. The brains of the system is a board with an STM32 microcontroller, and we get the standard power from a pulse converter. How is this all programmed to work with the axis? We will create variables and functions, peripheral settings, initialization of object display and display of graphic information, start ADC-DMA conversion, and in endless loop we solve three problems: converting ADC values into coordinates, displaying graphics on the screen, controlling an external LED. A schematic representation of a joystick is drawn with pseudo graphics. Moreover, the ADC values will be in absolute units and they must be converted to signed XL units. We apply the transformation procedure for each axis that is transferred from one range to another. Slider display procedure. Since the values for the axis have already been calculated, we display them on the display. Next, draw rectangles around the center point. Slider with 10 pixels. First, draw the background, when for each axis a different one. For the X axis, left or right. For the Y axis, top or bottom. External alert control procedure. We analyze the state variable of the button and draw the corresponding lines and control the LED. The signal from the button comes to the exit interrupt, which works on both edges. On the trailing edge, we catch the pressing, and on the leading edge, release the button. The signals from the joystick axis are configured as ADC. The button signal as input pull-up. This is due to its modification. See the electrical diagram. External LED is normal push-pull. When setting up DMA, we indicate that we are working with an ADC, we indicate the buffer for data, the number of channels, the dimension of the buffer and peripherals. DMA channel work is looped. When setting up the ADC, we indicate that we will work independently with several channels for a long time. The number of channels is 2. We configure them as regular channels. Turn on calibration and DMA binding. The EXTI settings are standard. We indicate that we will work on the leading and trailing edges. Bind the external pin to the EXTI modular. That's all. See you in the next video. Subscribe, Microcat.